What's up, guys? Charles here. Besides the graphics card, the CPU is the most exciting component of a build. Whether you're a gamer, power user, or professional, the CPU plays a pivotal role in your system. Many people, however, are still prone to believing some CPU myths that were busted a long time ago. Be it about the most important CPU specs, the dangers of modifying voltage and power settings, or the fear of bottlenecks, these myths might be keeping you from using your CPU to the fullest or pushing you to overspend on the CPU. Unlike overclocking, undervolting your CPU focuses on lowering temperature and power use rather than maximizing performance. Interestingly, a small benefit of this process is that your CPU can actually perform better when undervolted. This is because undervolting decreases the voltage and, as a result, the heat produced by the processor. Lower temperatures allow the CPU to sustain boost clocks for longer, enhancing overall performance. You stand to gain not only from higher 1% low FPS, but also from improved average FPS in gaming. By adjusting the voltage frequency curve of your CPU, you effectively enable it to achieve the same performance at a reduced voltage and power consumption. Results will vary among different users, but the belief that undervolting always reduces performance is simply incorrect. Many people regularly undervolt their CPU and enjoy a system that is high-performing, cool, and silent. Despite strong evidence favoring air coolers, many PC builders stick to liquid coolers out of habit, believing air cooling simply can't handle their power-hungry CPUs. While it's true that you definitely need AIO coolers to manage top-tier chips like the Core i9-14900K, Core Ultra 9-285K, Core Ultra 7-265K, or Ryzen 9-9950X, most users don't operate these monsters. Modern 6-core and 8-core CPUs can be effectively cooled with budget and mid-range air coolers. Economical air coolers like the Thermalright Phantom Spirit 120 are renowned for their cooling performance. For less than $40, you can realistically cool almost all mainstream CPUs. And if you invest a bit more in a Noctua cooler, you could even manage to cool the highest-end processors. Unless you're overclocking a high-end CPU or running extreme workloads, you'll have no problem running an air cooler on your PC. A CPU bottleneck sounds scary to most people. After all, if your CPU is stopping your system, specifically the GPU, from achieving maximum performance, you'd be worried too. However, many users see unusually high CPU usage and incorrectly conclude that their CPU is bottlenecking their PC. While a CPU bottleneck is one possible explanation behind high CPU usage, it can't be looked at in isolation. You might be playing CPU-demanding titles or gaming at 1080p, both of which can contribute to higher CPU usage than you'd usually expect. As the resolution increases, games become more GPU-bound, and you start seeing the load shift toward the graphics card. If you're noticing simultaneously high utilization of both the CPU and GPU, you might not have anything to worry about. Your system is well matched and is using the CPU and GPU to the fullest. Pairing a high-end CPU with other high-end components sounds natural, but you don't need an expensive CPU for high-end gaming. If your graphics card and the overall system are capable of high refresh rate 1440p and 4K gaming, you don't really need to shell out the big bucks for a high core count CPU or one of the Ryzen X3D chips. At higher resolutions like 4K, you'll almost always be GPU bound, and the CPU will become mostly irrelevant. It's not that the CPU isn't important at 4K, especially when rendering the game at a lower resolution during upscaling. The difference between different CPUs, however, can be highlighted only when they're paired with the most powerful graphics cards. If you aren't using an RTX 5090 or RTX 5080, you'll struggle to see any major difference between, say, a Ryzen 5, 7600X and Ryzen 7, 9800X3D. This leaves most people with little incentive to invest in anything more than a 6-core chip for gaming, and that's it for today's video. Do consider subscribing for all the latest content on gaming, and as always, I'll see you at the next one. Peace out.